La coqueta, la coqueta, you know who I am. FIFA 20 different and I feel like Uncle Sam. Texting all you haters cause you hate, I defend. Call the apps Tekashi cause all they do is bend. Broke boy, elite is what I like to choke boy. I am just a joke boy. Persecutes me, nom nom nom, I'm bok choy. Yeah, yeah, I'm a broke boy. Leave you swimming with the fishes, I am so coy. Opposition looking funny, joke coy. Class session, yeah, take some notes, boy. Broke boy.
What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy, One Star Week, and we are back for another episode of the Broke Boy Road to Glory. And summer heat is in full effect, and we're not talking about the weather. I mean, it's hot outside. But we're talking about the player that I asked you guys to vote for last episode. Pool of God has been brought from the heavens. And he is now on this game. And it's now in draft mode. He won the vote. I really thought Rabiot was going to win the vote. From what you guys were saying, I mean, a lot of people were looking for him to link Ribery, just to link their French teams, everything like that. But today, they dropped Pool of God, and here we are. We're going to be reviewing the Pulisic SBC. It was an 85 rated squad to do him, so it wasn't really a horrible value, given that he is a highly desired guard, given that he is an EPL left winger. So yeah, we're going to be talking about Pulisic today. I have nothing else to say. I hope you guys are doing great though at home and everything like that. So, when you look at this Christian Pool of God card, I mean, he's gotten a very, very big upgrade, if I do say so myself. He's 5'10". He has the high medium work rates. He's right-footed with a 4-star-4-star combination. I played 4 games in Division Rivals with him. I got 5 goals and 2 assists. Before I go any further though, if you're enjoying the content, if you want more content like this, do me a favor, hit the like button down below. And if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing to the channel. I appreciate all you guys at home for watching this video. So, when you look at this Pulisic card, I mean, comparing him to his not informed card, comparing him to his informed card, the one upgrade I really was hoping for here was a finishing upgrade, and he has gotten a massive shooting boost, which is great, honestly. His finishing is now a 91. He has 97 attack positioning, 99 shot power. So when you look at the most important stats here, as far as shooting goes, he has them in spades. His passing stats are great. He doesn't really quite have the long passing of a Cam, but at the same time, I don't think it should really harm him that much. His dribbling stats are absolutely insane. I mean, you've given Pulisic Neymar stats until you hit the composure stat. 81 composure. Is it gonna be a card killer? We're about to see. His physical stats are actually pretty respectable as well. He has a 99 in stamina and jumping, and 66 strength is not too shabby for the kind of player he is. So, without further ado, I'm gonna jump into the gameplay. I'm gonna let you guys know, should you do this Pulisic SBC? Let's go. All right, so according to Footbin, this card's gonna be costing you 100,000 coins to complete the SBC. Is he worth it? I would have to say absolutely. I think for 100K, you just can't go wrong. We're going to break down the stats though, so you know exactly what to expect. So, first we're going to talk about his pace, which is maxed out at 99. He has 99 acceleration, 95 sprint speed, and in-game, this guy feels rapid. And you really notice it when he comes out of the skill moves. Try a heel to heel. Try a L1 fake shot. This guy's going to blast out of them. It's just so difficult to keep up with him. His sprint speed being 95 means that once he's in behind the defense, he's staying in. That's it. Sayonara. Say goodbye. Overall, this guy's pace is a 10 out of 10. It is pretty much maxed out. Next, we're going to talk about shooting, and he really surprised me here, all right? Because I've never really used a Pulisic card that I would describe as clinical, but his shot was very good. We're going to start off with his attack positioning at 97, and just like very fast cards on this game, like him with high attack positioning, he's just very hard to contain, all right? Set him to get in behind. He's always going to be on the last defender, trying to run in behind, making aggressive runs, making intelligent runs, and it's really a sight to behold. His finishing at 91, I have to say, was pretty good. I think it was helped out by the sniper chem style, which supposedly brings it up to 99. He also has 99 shot power, so he had an accurate, very powerful shot that beat the keeper every time it was placed at the right spot. His 81 composure, I would say, did let him down from time to time. If you've ever used Kubo's summer heat card, he has 78 composure. And you'll notice with his 99 finishing, he doesn't quite feel like 99 finishing. Pulisic at times will miss shots under pressure. And it won't be a horrible miss. Maybe it'll just be a shot that you expected him to bury that'll instead be saved. But it is worth mentioning. Overall, this guy's shooting is a 9 out of 10. It's solid, and if you play him on the wing, he's going to be a very, very good finisher for you. Next, we want to talk about his passing, and this is an underrated aspect of his card because nobody's really bringing Pulisic in to be a playmaker, but that's what he is on this game. He has 97 vision, 98 short passing, 90 curve. So in and around the box, his passing, his weight of his passing is very, very nice. His long passing is actually pretty good as well. I didn't really notice it being a liability at all. His crossing, of course, is going to be very nice if you like those low-driven crosses. And overall, this guy's passing is a 9 out of 10. Next, we'll talk about his dribbling. How does it feel in game? I mean, every stat here almost is maxed out. The lowest stat here, of course, is the composure. But first, we're going to talk about his dribbling. And I would say it's very, 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 very good. He feels so shifty, so responsive on the ball. The moment you just wiggle the joystick, he's already ready to shimmy, ready to beat a defender. It's very, very nice. His close ball control is very, very, very good. I didn't really notice his composure really affecting him when he was being pressured while he was dribbling. He was able to shift, beat a defender, a second defender, a third defender. It was very, very nice. Of course, because of his acceleration, he does burst out of the skill moves as well, and it makes him very dangerous. He can go from being at a dead stop to bursting out of a skill move before you even blink your eyes. It's crazy. And his composure, like I said, I didn't really notice it affecting him except for certain finishes. So overall, this guy's dribbling is a 9.5 out of 10. If you enjoy players that are good on the ball, yeah, this guy's amazing on the ball. Finally, we'll be talking about his physical, and there are some important stats here. 99 stamina, of course, is the most important stat here. He's going to last all game. He has 99 jumping, which means that he will be able to win his fair share of headers. His heading accuracy is pretty poor, though, and headers are dead, so I wouldn't really think it's an amazing thing to have either way. His strength means that he can ride a challenge from here or there, but he's not going to be very, very strong to shield for very, very long. Overall, this guy's physical is a 7.5 out of 10. Alright guys, so what's the final verdict on this card? I think this card is an amazing card for what you get for the value. I mean, he's 100k. You can't really get anything on this game for 100k that's going to be better than this card. He has the pace, the dribbling is insane, and his finish is highly reliable. His one weakness, I would say, is his mediocre composure at 81. That's why I threw a sniper camp style on him, which theoretically should bring that to 86. I think his passing is very good as well. And overall, I think if you're looking for a winger in the Premier League, if you're an American fan, definitely gotta check out this card. All right, guys, so that's gonna be my Pulisic review. Hopefully, you guys at home enjoyed it. Once again, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next episode, but until then,